Hello and welcome to my workshop. In this video, we're going to be doing some photography. Product photography can be divided into two main categories. One of them is the catalog photographs, which is your product, a white background, and then you slap it on the website. And the other one is what I call stage photographs, in which you add certain additional elements that either contrast or complement your product, and that gives a little bit more of an appeal to the whole image overall. What we're going to be focusing today is that staged photograph. The thing we're going to be photographing today is this beautiful emperor style fountain pen made with Amboyna Burl, and here is the fountain pen nib. Now, I know most of my videos have been doing custom work, such as the campsite sign or the memorial frame or even the display cabinets, but my most popular product is still writing instruments. So that's your good old-fashioned ballpoint, rollerball, fountain pens, and even pencils, along with their pen cases. I mean, they're perfect gift for any occasion, such as birthday, anniversary, Christmas, promotion, demotion, and they're good for anybody as well. And in fact, this particular pen, or the rollerball version of this pen, along with two others, are going to Germany at the end of this particular shoot. Now, let's focus on the staging. Since I'm photographing a fountain pen, something related to writing is the perfect setting for it. So my idea is to have a piece of paper, and I'm using a piece of an acrylic just to give that little flat surface. In case you're wondering, it's not a magic paper. And so you're gonna have a piece of paper, something half written on it, and then the pen sitting on top to give the idea that something is currently being written, and then shoot it from an angle similar to what I have right now. That way the letters at the beginning are going to be blurred, and then in full focus is going to be the fountain pen nib. So now, what to do for paper? Regular printing paper is okay. Using your regular pads are okay, but then they have those lines, so it doesn't look sexy at all. And then I kind of went and stumbled upon pieces of scrap shoji paper that I've had when I was gluing the diffusers for my table lamps. So I kind of figured, okay, well, this is good, nice and thick paper, paper with a little character in it. So why not use this one and make it look like a scroll? So eventually you're gonna see me turning this around to create that little nice curl in the paper. So that's what I'm gonna be using. Now, the question is what to use for text. Obviously I can write any type of gibberish, but that's gonna look funny and look stupid. So I kind of relied something from my heritage, and I'm Bulgarian by birth, and we have used in the past the so-called glagolitic alphabet, which is basically something like this. They look a little bit like runestones, so that's going to give a little bit of a mystique to that fountain pen, and coupled with the shoji paper and the scroll look, it's going to look like I'm writing a ancient scroll. So I took a piece of text from a book and converted that into the glagolitic alphabet. And right now I'm going to be transferring at least portion of this paragraph onto that shoji paper. And here's how I'm going to do it. So here's how I'm going to do it. What I have here is a little frame display with a glass on top. That used to be a display case from an artist who has retired from doing craft shows. So I'm going to have that. I'm going to shine light behind it. And then I'm going to transpose the paper onto the shoji paper. So I'm not sure if it's clearly visible on the camera, but I can see the letters, and I'll basically slowly transcribe the way from the printed paper onto the shoji paper. That way it's going to look like it's being written. And of course we're going to have that little offset and a little movement, so it doesn't look like it's actually made from a printer, but handwritten as well. Now, I believe this is going to be one of the most time-consuming pieces of the project, so I'm going to get right to it. And I'm going to zoom in so that we can see how the nib glides onto the paper. Of course, this is shoji paper, completely different properties than regular paper. It is a bit more porous, and the shoji paper, I believe, is made with rice, so we know how rice loves moisture. So it will be sucking a lot more of the ink than regular paper. So I just have to really glide it and adjust the weight that I put on the nib so that it gives the right amount of ink to place something on it, but not make it look like a big blob like I have in this case right here. So let's get to it. And this is the proposed setup. We have the parchment paper, if you want to call it that. The way to get a curl is basically roll the paper like this and give it a nice tight wind, and that's what it does. And the idea is to place the pen where the wording ends right here, the cap somewhere behind, and that gives the idea that the work is currently being written. And then I'm going to use my phone to take sample photos, and I'm going to place the phone somewhere right here at about this angle, and then take the photo. And of course the focus will be on the pen nib. Now I only have one camera, and that is used to record the current video, so when it's time to actually do the photos with the camera, that footage may be missing from the video, but you can definitely see what I'm doing, because the place where I put the phone is the place where I'm gonna put the camera. So just imagine that the phone is the camera, and that's how I'm taking the picture. So the picture took, and I'm gonna put it on the video, and I see two problems. Problem number one is there's way too many reflections on top of the pen. As you can see here, it picks up all the reflections from the workshop, and considering the number of things that I have, it's a lot. And the other thing is the pen cap, I cannot really see the nice accents that are on the clip, and I'm just gonna give them a little bit of a closer look so you can see the accents. The cap is a little bit heavier, so it always falls onto the clip and it's kind of hidden behind it. So how to solve for that issue? Well, I'm going to resort to something very common, and that is basically CD cases that I haven't put into the recycle bin yet. So it's quite simple. I'm just gonna lift them. I'm just gonna lift the acrylic, that is, onto those CD cases. That's gonna create a slope. So now everything is gonna go backwards. So what I'm gonna do next is place a little stopper, and now I can basically have the cap pointing in almost any direction that I need. Now I need to put the same stopper for the pen as well, otherwise it will roll over. So let's do something like this. And you can use a piece of wood, a piece of cotton, a piece of something that will bind against the pen. I wouldn't say bind is a bad word, but something that's gonna rest against the pen and prevent it from rolling over, just like I have in my case. And I'm gonna take another picture, sample picture, focusing onto the pen nib. 3, 2, 1, click. So picture taken, and now the only problem is the extra reflections. For that, I have made a special conical device with a single eye. That's where the camera is gonna look. So I'm gonna place it on top. And I'm gonna retake that same picture that I took earlier. Okay, 3, 2, 1, click. And we see that there is absolutely no reflections aside from a one special black reflection that is made on purpose. And the reason for the black diffraction is something that I'm gonna put towards the end of the video so that we can see the difference between this setup and the exact same setup without that black line. And basically that's what the picture would look like. I'm gonna of course use my big lights to shine light on top of it, and I'm gonna do that adjustment. But basically that is the image that I'm looking for. So let me take the pictures and we'll see what happens towards the end. So I am using my phone to record at least the last steps of the whole photography process. So I have my setup right here. We have one of the strobe lights, then we have the camera, then we have the cone with the pen inside, and that's what it looks like on the camera screen. And I also have my bigger camera screen right there, just for good measure. And then I have my second light. So everything up until now has been mostly adjusting the settings, either the settings of the camera or the settings of the lights, the positioning of the pens inside there. And I'll give you a little preview. So for example, if my aperture is set at 11 and I take a picture, let me use my remote shutter so that I don't shake the camera. And then we play the image. We can see that at the back here, not everything is in focus. But if we switch the camera and we put our aperture to f22, which is the highest aperture, and then we have to raise the output of the lights, and we take the same picture and we play it along on the monitor. Then we can see that everything at the back is also in focus. So these are all the things that I've been dealing with for the past couple of hours, and there was no need to include that, otherwise you'll be falling asleep. So that's basically it, just taking the pictures and modifying the settings whenever they need modification. So I'm a few steps away from actually the final image, and that's what it's going to look like. And let's just go back and see how everything flashes. And there we are. And I'll see you in a moment after I process the pictures and I'll put them on the screen as well. And now for the moment you've been waiting for, glossy versus matte. Now this is not a championship match in any type of sport. The comparison arises from this. An image is a two-dimensional media that represents a three-dimensional object. And within that image we are trying to portray color, shape, size, and also the material from which the object is made from. In the two images that you see right now, let me know which one do you think makes the metal look glossy and which one do you think makes the metal look matte. Use the comments below and let me know. If you like this video, make sure to like, share and subscribe, and also hit the notification bell to get notified of my future video uploads. Also, follow me on all social media channels and consider supporting me on Patreon. All the links are down in the description.